Good morning, NAFL Centro. I wanted to update you on some changes to upcoming events across the base. As COVID-19 continues to spread, and with the recent dramatic rise in both case numbers and positive percentage, I am changing our approach to some near-term planned events. As you know already, I've canceled the Turkey for the Troops potluck, which was planned for later today. We just couldn't get to yes on the medical protocols for that type of meal. However, we're extremely thankful to the Navy League for their donation to the base of over 150 turkeys for the families, and we know those will be put to good use. Now, regarding the Thanksgiving meal, I ask you all to use good sense. Numbers should be kept as small as possible and with as few households as possible mixing together. Even small mixed events with as few as 3 to 4 different households have shown to be causal factors in lateral spread of the disease, primarily due to a laxness in distancing and wearing of masks in those events. I further advise you to take advantage of the wonderful temperature we have right now. And if you're having guests over, entertain outdoors as much as you're able. And we've also had to cancel our planned Turkey Trot 5K. However, I do challenge you to get outside and do some physical activity before settling down for your Thanksgiving meal. Walk, run, bike, anything that gets you moving will recharge your mental and physical batteries. Now, looking past Thanksgiving, I've also canceled next week's planned Holiday of Lights parade. However, starting this weekend, you may change out your holiday home decorations to winter celebration. And as we did for Halloween, we'll be giving out awards for the best decorated house. We'll make that vote on the 12th of December, so you have time to get ready. Many of you did a wonderful job over Halloween, and I can't wait to see your Christmas spirit. Additionally, because the environment has changed, we've had to close some facilities on base and reduce the opening hours for others. I'm doing this because I've asked for a reduction in people coming aboard the base, and I'm limiting those at work to the minimum required to execute our mission as an additional step to protect us all. Our Facebook page updated just yesterday the new hours for those affected services. Now, one last thing. Santa and I have been in contact, and he asked me to provide some updates to pass along. First, he's sending me a special Santa mailbox, which will be set up in the gazebo next to the Lincoln Housing Splash Zone. Now, this mailbox should be here sometime next week, and we'll make a posting to let everybody know when that's been delivered. Now, he asked for two things. If you drop off a Christmas letter to Santa in that mailbox, he's promised he'll come back and empty that box in time for his elves to make those special gifts for delivery, only if you're on the good list. And remember, he checks that list twice for accuracy. Now, secondly, Santa's asked me for permission to bring his sleigh aboard for family photos on Friday, the 4th of December. Families can come by the gazebo at from 1300 to 1600 that Friday afternoon, drop off your letter if you haven't done so already, and also take a family photo with Santa. Now, we need to protect Santa and maintain a good physical distance, so he'll sit on his special Santa seat, and we'll have a place for families to stand or seat for a photo distant from Santa. Now, if you're waiting in line to see Santa, I ask you to keep more than 6 feet away from all the other families to protect all of us and to protect Santa. And he's promised he'll come back to base, retrieve all the letters, and in case you don't see him that day, and then he'll be back one last time on Christmas Eve for final delivery. So thank you all very much for everything you're doing for the base mission and for the work you've been doing keeping COVID at bay. Now, stay tuned tomorrow for our Thanksgiving holiday message with more information. Have a wonderful day.